My name is David Gonzalez. I'm president and founder of World of Dance and also the executive producer of World of Dance on NBC. I'm really looking forward to just connecting with all the youth. I have a passion to give back. Actually, that's one of the reasons why I produce World of Dance. It's a young audience, and to just give back to people is amazing. I think the one message that I'm going to focus on a little bit is the understanding of connections, relationships, and basically flow. I'm hoping that the students get out of this conversation understanding that we're all equal. Ideas come from each of us at different times, and whether that idea comes from myself or whether that idea comes from an individual, the reality is I might have more experience, but an idea is the foundation of every business, and it's always about just having the idea and execution from that point.
Mr. David Gonzalez, we are grateful that you are here and we're ready to receive that knowledge and wisdom from you. And so, how did it all happen?
Well, before saying how it all happened, I did want to say thank you, FSA, for bringing me out here in TFCU. Beyond the story that I'm going to tell you about how it happened, I want you to hopefully connect with the understanding that anyone can do anything. It's just a matter of putting your mind to it. So that's kind of an underlying message, and I'm going to explain to you how I put my mind to it and how it got to where it is today. But I guess first question, the journey. I've been involved in entertainment for over 25 years now, probably 30 years now. And at one point in time, I was actually very attached to the Filipino community. There was a club organization that I threw that was called Legend Entertainment in California. We were organizing a lot of like the Filipino events, that kind of culture. And through being involved in that, a friend of mine had actually said, hey, you know, I want to do this car show. And at the period of time, there weren't car shows in the community. And I had two friends. One of them was producing something called Import Show Off. The other friend was producing something called Hot Import Nights. And basically, they were both asking me, they said, you know, you own this club scene so well. Is there a way that you can partner with me in some capacity? And I chose to actually work with Hot Import Nights. And for probably 5 or 6 years of working with that company, it grew to be something really big. And I learned a few things in that movement. I learned that being a part of the car culture was what actually introduced me to the dance culture. But because I was not an owner in that operation, I had learned what it's like to be an owner and said, the next time I go around and do this, I want to do this for myself, and I want to do it my way, and I want to do it for a community that I care about. And what was interesting was the community that I was so passionate about at that given time was basically the Filipino-American community, quite honestly with you, because what had happened was the B-boys and the crews, they were all performing at our events, and all of those people were saying, hey, you know, you guys have Pepsi as a sponsor, you have this, you have that. How can we bring that to dance? And it actually kept coming up in conversation and conversation with different people. And when I finally realized my path with Hot Import Nights was done, I said, you know, I want to create something. And I want to create something that I give to the world. And that was the World of Dance.
You hear that? Ooh, wow. Ooh. That was magical. So, you know, starting something, like we have these visions and goals and aspirations, but just to start something is the hardest, one of the hardest things. How does one go about starting their vision?
Yeah, I think it is important. In 2011, which was 1 year after we started World of Dance, I had wrote down at that point in time that it would be the largest media company in the dance space. I'd written down in that time that we were going to be a global competition. The name in itself was World of Dance Tour from day one. Even though we were producing one event, the first event, we were calling it a tour because we knew that it was bigger than just one thing. We knew that this is going to be something that we could develop into something big. And you have to see it big from the beginning, even though you start small. And I think that was part of the key. You know, the other part of the key is when you're creating, you have to think of what you want to create and not let somebody jeopardize your vision. Stay true to your vision, because in the very beginning, we were told that the break dancers, you know, they're in this universe. The urban choreography, they're in that universe. You know, the crumpers, that's a different scene. They're all in different scenes. And I was saying, oh, we're going to bring it all together and we're going to put it under one roof. And people said, no, it doesn't work that way. And in my mind, I was saying, well, I produced these car shows, and the B-boys were over there, and the choreography was over here, and the crumpers and the jerkers and the this and the that were everywhere, so why is it not going to work in dance culture? And everybody actually in the culture was telling me why it wouldn't work, but I had told myself that I know it will work because I've already seen aspects of it taking place. So I think the key is to have a strong vision and hold yourself accountable to that vision and make sure that people are going to say what they have to say about that vision. And sometimes you do have to shift left or right, but at the end of the day, you also have to steer your ship. And if you steer your ship with a clear vision, only time will allow that vision to take place, and you get from point A to point B, and you just keep going.
Beautiful. And Joyce said the exact same thing, writing it down and keeping that vision in front of you all the time. And so let's go ahead and get into flow and relationships. Tell us about that.
Yeah, flow and relationships. This is something that is very, very important to me. Relationships are so powerful, and people do not understand the power of the relationship. You guys sitting in the audience don't understand right now the power of the person sitting next to you or behind you or in front of you. The reality is these people have not found their path yet, or maybe some of you have, but all of you will. And the thing that's interesting is if you understand the power of relationships at an early age, I wish somebody would have taught me this. I really wish somebody would have taught me this. There were days back when I was the club promoter where I had Beyonce performing. I had, you know, everything from Ice Cube to NWA coming to our clubs on like the hardcore side. I mean, there was all kinds of people that crossed my path. The Black Eyed Peas, a number of people. And at the time I had viewed it as these are performers that weren't the stars that they are today. So my value in the relationship wasn't defined. I didn't understand how important those people would be at that given time. So if there's a gift that I can give you, it's understanding the relationship now and building that relationship authentically, because the person sitting next to you is going to be a power mover at one point in time. And not everyone has to be a power player. It's not about brands and names and this and that. It's about what people know. Everyone will have a path. Everyone will develop a skill. All of you will develop a good skill. And the key is to figure out how does that good skill set work so that you can work amongst people. Everything is built off of people working together. And I want to kind of give you an example. Does anyone know what the flow state is? Have you ever heard of that before? If you've heard of flow state, raise your hand. Okay, there's probably two people, maybe three or four, that understand what flow state is. Flow state is when you're riding a wave, like surfing as an example, and you're catching that wave, you're paddling it, and then you're in that moment, time disappears. In that moment, all your body functions are working, you're kind of balancing, you're thinking of the wave behind you, you're understanding an environment without even understanding the environment. That's flow state. When you are a basketball player or an athlete, and you're dribbling through the legs and you're figuring things out and you can't be stopped, that moment that you can't be stopped is flow state. What I think is interesting is a lot of people refer to flow state as one moment in time, meaning like right now, flow state, like I'm in the zone right in this moment. You guys are allowing me to be in flow state right now. I think the misconception about flow state is it's not connected to time all the time. Flow state is actually connected to relationships, because the more you build your relationship pool, the quicker you are to be able to maneuver through the obstacles and challenges in life. And to me, when you're building business with people. You're not building it by yourself. You're building it with a staff. You're building it with a people. You're building it with a vision. And you know what? The more relationships you have, the stronger your vision can materialize, and the quicker you can connect people, the more you become in flow state. So for me, flow state is an everyday feeling of being able to get to the next level faster, smarter, and with people that can help you get that vision to come alive. And a lot of people say like, oh, in work, you know, there's those moments in time. No, there is no time. The moment is now, and now is forever. So be in flow state. Make the connections, relate with one another, understand skills, work together, and you will get there.
I felt like I was in a flow state as you were talking. Like, I feel like I'm flowing. So I just want to make sure I get this and the audience get this. How do you start the flow state? Like, I want to get in flow state.
I want to get there. I want to get there now.
Yeah.
I think that the best way to get into flow state is first to understand what it is. So if you understand what it is, it's basically taking time away from the equation and understanding your goal. And once you understand your goal, then you have to understand who in the world can you work with to make that goal happen. A lot of businesses start with like financing and this and that. Our business didn't start with that. It started with a vision. Like I credit multiple people for different aspects of that vision. But one of the founders, Myron Martin, he told me, hey, I want to produce a dance competition. I said, hey, okay, a dance competition is cool, but we need to produce something bigger. That's where the name World of Dance came about. And when we created World of Dance and said it was a media company and said it would be sponsored and said it would be a tour and said it would be international, it was kind of like, oh yeah, that's great. That, you know, my partners were saying that's all great, that it could get to that level. But I'm like, no, it's not going to get to, it is going to get to that level. We're going to take it to that level. And again, the way you get into flow state is really in understanding the relationship pools you have and the people that you have access to. Because a lot of times what happens is you will pick two or three resources in the beginning, and maybe those are your friends, your peers, your mom, your dad, your advisors, and maybe your flow state is just it's like a spark. It happens, and then it kind of goes away, right? Because you've tapped your resources, you've asked for help, everyone was into the vision, and then all of a sudden, like, it kind of like goes away. Part of the understanding of flow state is not to allow it to go away. Flow flows. You know, the river flows. It flows down. There's a boulder in the middle. You don't hit the boulder and then you're done. You hit the boulder and you flow around that boulder. Whatever your obstacle is, you find your way to figure out who can help you create that flow. And at the end of the day, the flow from A to Z is your life journey. And all we have is our lives journey. All we have is now. I don't have tomorrow. You know, I hope I have tomorrow. But I don't have tomorrow. What I have is right now. If right now I can teach you guys to understand the value of a relationship, then you guys can develop your own state of flow, your own relationships, your own understanding, and hopefully apply to your own vision.
Just reminded me of that Bruce Lee quote, be like water, my friend.
Be like water. Flow.
So, yeah, when you are in flow, and as you said, it sometimes just feels like it happens every now and then. When you're in flow, challenges come up. Like, nothing could stop you when you're in flow, but we'll get in our own heads and start kind of doubting and start worrying, like, and then therefore we're out of flow and we feel detached from it. I understand that when you're in flow, you just keep on going no matter what. But again, for those that are still grasping this concept, which is extremely powerful, what do we do when that happens?
Yeah, there's been countless times where flow has stopped. And you know, you ask yourself, like, why are things not working? Like, how do I bring this flow back? And I think the answer to that is tenacity. Failure does not exist unless you quit. That is the only way that failure can exist. If you see things from point A to point Z and never make it to Z, that's okay, as long as you don't quit. So in my life, I don't have failure because I will never quit. That's just how my life, that's how I've accepted life. Now, I may hit that brick in the wall or that boulder in the river, and I may have to ask people and advisors and friends, like, how do I get around this? And sometimes people don't even have an answer. And sometimes people say, that's not even worth going around, you know, but through advice of people, they'll get you to the right answer. And then you have to trust your instinct in yourself. The other thing is, just because you've written down one path doesn't mean that that path is exactly as you write it. The path is changing and the path is flowing. So the reality is, if you could create flow state, if you could create relationships, if you could create friendships, camaraderie, trust, if you can create all those things, you guys will flow just as I have. And this is something that is achievable for everyone.
Could you talk about maybe an example of where you were in flow with World of Dance and then that barrier happened, but you moved past it because of flow?
Yeah, I can provide you guys with some an example. When we created the World of Dance on NBC, which was an extension from the organization, it was basically a licensing agreement that NBC was going to help develop the show forward. There was a lot of people saying, "Wait a minute, you know, what's going on? Are you selling out this way?" There was that conversation. There was other people saying, "Wait a minute, what's going on? You're changing how it's judged that way. Wait a minute, you know, what's going on? You're adding this style or that style." And a lot of people were coming at me with different aspects of like, you know, you guys, or you, because I was talking with NBC, you are changing how the essence of what World of Dance was. Now, let me explain the essence of World of Dance. Remember, it was supposed to be the World of Dance. And in the beginning, it was urban, it was choreography, it was b-boys, it was crumping. When you're going after an audience, you have to go after a common audience. So the urban side spoke to me. That's where my roots are as a DJ, as a promoter. That's what spoke to me. And that's what we initially developed. When NBC wanted to take it to the next level, all of a sudden the conversation was, wait, you're gonna take different worlds of dance and put them together. And I said, well, yeah, exactly. We're going to do that because that's what we already did. We brought different worlds, even though they were like-minded at the time. That was the whole premonition of World of Dance to begin with. And now that we've shifted to an entertainment platform, we're still bringing worlds of dance together. They're just more worlds now. So to a certain extent, people always ask, you know, is NBC's World of Dance and the organizational side of World of Dance the same? And my answer is yes, they are the same, because they understand the same mission. World of Dance's mission is to give a creative platform of competition to the dance community. That's what it was 10 years ago. That's what it is to this day. It's just changed because it's evolved and it's flowed, and that's what it is at this point in time.
That's amazing. You know, you brought up failure, how failure doesn't exist. And, you know, I was told this acronym for FAIL. It stands for finding answers in life, right? And failure also is, you know, nothing more than feedback and being able to adjust. And so for you, like adjusting to that feedback and to keep on staying with that flow, what inspires you to just keep on going to that next level?
Yeah, I think that when I say failures don't exist, that does not mean that I've not failed a million times over. We fail on things all the time. So it's not that it doesn't exist, it's that I don't quit and that I learn from that failure and move on. What inspires me to move things forward in World of Dance is that I still feel that it hasn't scratched the surface of what it can be. Until I feel like I have done everything that I can do for that community, I won't let it go. Now, there comes a time where a business reaches a plateau and maybe it gets harder. I don't feel we're there yet with World of Dance, but there's also a time where you have to look at yourself, because I am not World of Dance. World of Dance is a platform. I am a contributor to building that platform. The platform is there for the community as a whole, regardless of which dance community we're talking about. But I myself have a passion. I have a passion to build World of Dance, and I have a passion to build some other projects. There's new projects that I'm developing in my mindset. And in those new projects, I'm taking along old friends from back in the day, and I'm taking on current friends from World of Dance. And that's what I'm talking about with relationships and flow. It's not, World of Dance is not my, that's not my end. That's just my current. And I feel like I will always be in a space of developing something. And I hope that through building more and more relationships with people, you know, God willing, that opportunities always come back to me. So that's where I'm going, at least, and that's, I believe in World of Dance. I will stay involved in World of Dance, but I also believe that I as an individual am capable of more, and I don't want to stop. We're only on this earth for so long, so do what you can.
And so for those, last question, and so for those that want to start that movement that's big, like bigger than the world, or have these like big goals and dreams and visions, what do you advise them to do?
I think that if you're going to dream big, my advice would probably be don't be afraid of your own dream. I think that a lot of people, they dream about something big or maybe even something small, but they're afraid of their own dream. They're basically, I don't know if I can do this. I don't know if I should give up what I'm doing to do that. You know, people talk themselves out of their own potential. And I think potential is infinite. You just have to believe in yourself.
Awesome. I feel like I could be in flow with this conversation forever, like water, my friend. Let's go ahead and give David another huge round of applause.